Trump keeps America great on Asia trip, refuses to bow to Japanese emperor. One day at a time, President Donald Trump is doing his best to keep his promise to the American people and make America great again. Case in point, on Monday, when meeting Japanese Emperor Akihito, Trump stood tall like a real leader, nodded his head and shook the emperor's hand. If you'll recall, when former President Barack Obama greeted the emperor in November of 2009, he bowed fully in what was perceived as a sign of weakness and submission. Obama also generated a wave of criticism when he appeared to bow to King Abdullah of Saudi Arabia upon meeting him in April of the same year, according to news reports. Un-American president's conduct, especially when overseas, is a serious matter because he represents our Constitution as well as the American people. When the leader of the free world bows before other world leaders, it sends the wrong message. The former president might not have known how to represent a free country around foreign dignitaries, but Trump obviously does. An administration official traveling with Trump on his Far East tour told the UK Daily Mail that bowing was not his style, never has been. The move didn't go unnoticed. Some people might have problems with how Trump is running the country, but very few people could ever accuse the president of appearing weak or docile, like his predecessor. Trump kicked off his two-week tour of Asia in Japan, where he reportedly met with senior leadership to discuss issues ranging from trade to North Korea. The president and first lady will also visit South Korea, China, Vietnam, and the Philippines. In a statement, the White House said that during this trip, Trump aimed to underscore his commitment to long-standing United States alliances and partnerships, and reaffirm United States leadership in promoting a free and open Indo-Pacific region. And that doesn't include bowing. Trump is expected to return to Washington on November 13th.